Your tax dollars from the Legacy Fund will no longer pay to send Minnesota artists overseas. We first told you about these trips back in March. Artists traveling to experience different cultures. Well, Jay Kolls broke the story, and he's here now to explain what lawmakers did to stop this. Jay?
Well, Leah, this isn't a bad place to visit, especially if someone else pays for it. Lawmakers saw our story in March, and before the session was over, they took action to change the spending habits at the Minnesota Arts Board. And they did it decisively, both Republicans and Democrats.
The sapphire waters of Bora Bora, not bad. The deep green of New Zealand and the tropics of Costa Rica, all nice destination trips for artists paid for with taxpayer money. What we found caught the attention of state lawmakers in the Senate.
Many of you are aware of the Channel 5 Eyewitness News story.
I saw the same report. I was concerned. I talked to folks at the State Arts Board.
And in the House of Representatives, too.
As some of you may be aware, KSTP about a month ago reported on grants that were being provided by the State Arts Board.
Lawmakers didn't like taxpayer money, about 15% of a $5.6 million arts initiative program, paying for overseas travel for artists. Some of that money coming from the Legacy Fund.
But is it really a good use of taxpayer dollars? This is an opportunity for us to refocus Minnesota taxpayer dollars to be used in Minnesota.
And so they did. Republicans and Democrats voted overwhelmingly to restrict paid travel for artists using taxpayers' money from the Legacy Fund to just travel inside Minnesota.
Thanks to your work on this story and thanks to Senator Cohen's assistance on the floor, if that clear message isn't received by the Arts Board, then I think it's appropriate the legislature put firmer measures in place.
And Senator Benson says the restrictive language was taken out of the bill during conference committee because the Arts Board told lawmakers they did get the message and will no longer use legacy money for out-of-state travel. We called and emailed the communications director for the Arts Board this afternoon, but we didn't hear back from him, Leah.
Okay, so what are lawmakers going to do then to make sure that the Arts Board is following these rules?
Well, Senator Benson, I asked her that because it's one thing to put it in legislation and they have to by law, but she said they can track the legacy funding through the Office of Management and Budget, and they intend to do that, and if the Arts Board doesn't do what they've asked them to do, they'll go back and make it law.
All right. And I think they were all excited to be watching your 5 Eyewitness News report last time.
They mentioned it a couple times.
Did.
It was very nice of them.
All right, Jake, thank you. Bill? Mm-hmm.